to verse 10. 2 Kings chapter 7. I'm going to start from verse 3 to verse 10. The word of God says, now there were four leprous men at the entrance of the gate, and they said to one another, why are we sitting here until we die? If we say we will enter the city, the famine is in the city, and we shall die there. And if we sit here, we die also. Now, therefore, come, let us surrender to the army of the Syrians. If they keep us alive, we shall live. And if they kill us, we shall only die. And they rose at twilight to go to the camp of the Syrians. And when they had come to the outskirts of the Syrians' camp, to their surprise, no one was there. For the Lord had caused the army of the Syrians to hear the noise of the chariots and the noise of horses, the noise of a great army. So they said to one another, look, the king of Israel has had against us the kings of the Hittites and the kings of the Egyptians to attack us. Verse 7. Therefore, they arose and fled at twilight and left the camp intact, their tents, their horses, and their donkeys. And they fled for their lives. And when these lepers came to the outskirts of the camp, they went into one tent and ate and drank and carried from it silver and gold and clothing and went and hid them. Then they came back and entered another tent and carried some from there also and went and hid it. Then they said to one another, we are not doing right. This day is a day of good news. And we remain silent. If we wait until morning light, some punishment will come upon us. Now therefore, come, let us go and tell the king's household. So they went and called to the gatekeepers of the city and told them, saying, we went to the Syrian camp, and surprisingly no one was there, not a human sound, only horses and donkeys tired, and the tent intact. And the gatekeepers called out, and they told it to the king's household inside. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful morning that you have given us and for your word. And I pray that the Holy Spirit will help us this morning to be blessed by your word. In Jesus' name. Amen. Can we say amen?
Amen.
Can we clap our hands to our God? You may be seated. Hallelujah. Can you wave to me, please? My title this morning and for this month is this one. Hallelujah.
Is that English?
Yes. Say amen.
Amen.
When I was preparing that, this message, actually, I know that I've got to do something. And then it came in my mind, is this the correct English? I have to ask someone, is that correct English? And also, I asked my daughter, Marianne. Hallelujah. You see these children? They come to this world very little, especially for us, whom English is the second language. They are born in our families. We teach them ABC. After a while, we take them to kindergarten. They start learning. We teach them, this is how you say this word and that word. Actually, we begin by telling them, say daddy. They say daddy, daddy, daddy. They make mistakes sometimes. Say mama. Mama. After what? They start correcting us. You are fed up with the kind of life you have.
sit down, until you rise up and you do something, being broke will continue. That situation will not change by itself. Hallelujah. We read 2 Kings chapter 7 from verse 3 to 10. It is a story about four lepers. As part one, I'm going to give you four examples of people who were tired of their situation and they decided to do something. And when they decided, miracles happened. Hallelujah. You have to do something. Four lepers. They were outside the camp. They were outside of the wall. The children of Israel were besieged by the Syrian army. And because these people were lepers, they were told that they are not supposed to be in the crowd. They were cast. They were not supposed to be in the crowd. In the other people, in the community, we don't need you here. You don't belong here. You have a leprosy. You are a leper. You are not supposed to be here. You need to be. They were separated from other community. So they were put outside to die there. Because the moment they could show up in the community could stop, could storm them. They were supposed to be stoned to death if they mingle with other people. So they were put outside to die there. And remember, there were also hunger. Famine continued inside the Israelites. Where they were famine there. They could not go outside because outside there were a great army which was more powerful than themselves. So they kept inside, fearing going outside. And the Bible says there were famine there. People were dying for lack of food. And outside there were four lepers put outside. People were not supposed to be in the crowd. Were put outside to die there. These people are so genius, I can say. They reached to the conclusion, we're going to do something or we're going to die here. We're going to do something or we're going to die here without food. What they did, people of God, they made a decision. You have to do something. I've got to do something. They said, if we remain here, we're going to die here. Because people don't want to see us out inside. Even if we go there, there is no food inside. And if we remain here, we're going to die by hunger. But if we go to the Syrians, they're going to kill us. These people are our enemies. They're going to kill us. So what are we going to do? Have you reached to a crossroad whereby you cannot go to the front, you cannot go back, you cannot go to the left, you cannot go to the right? Where you are, you have to make a tough decision. I believe every one of us has been in a crossroad at a certain point. If you have not been there, it is coming. But I believe every one of us, to some point, you have reached to a a point whereby you don't know what to do. You feel like the world is against you. You don't know what to do. These four lepers, they reached to that point where they knew we have to do something or we're going to die. And I'm challenging you this morning, people of God, do something or else things will remain the way they are. Hallelujah. They said, okay, this is what we're going to do. We're going to face our enemies. We are not going to die here. We're going to go and meet our enemies. Why? That they have what we need. They have food in there. Because where we are, we don't have food. Inside the camp, there is no food. There are dying people there. But we're going to go and face them right there where they are, our enemies. They have food. If they're going to kill us, that's fine. Yeah, we're going to die anyway. But if they're going to spare us, we're going to live because they have food. Hallelujah. So what happened, people of God? They didn't make decision to stay where they were. They made decision to go forward. To go forward. Let me tell you, people of God, you are in the crossroad in one way or another. Let me tell you, this is not the time for you to sit down. This is not time for you to cry. It is time to go forward. It is time to go forward. Talk to your neighbor and tell him, oh, it is time to go forward. We don't go back here. We go forward. The Bible says when they start walking, it's when the miracle took place. The moment they start walking is when they saw the mighty hand of God. They were just four lepers. Four lepers. They start walking. I grew up in a city in Africa called Mwanza. In Mwanza, on those years, right now they have controlled leprosy. On those years, it was hard to control leprosy, and there were a lot of leprosy people around in Mwanza. Leprosy, it is a very bad disease. Leprosy eats your body. It kills your nails. You cannot, sometimes you step on fire, you can't realize that you're on fire because of leprosy. It is a very bad disease. It eats your feet, your hip, your hands, your fingers.
Whatsoever you desire,
When they start walking, they were just four people. Maybe they had discussion. How about you look?
Man, I'm not going to sit down here and die here.
How about you, Thomas?
Man, I know my dad did everything, but I'm going to die here if I continue with my dad here.
How about you, Matthew? No, I'm going with you. I'm in one bench, yes. Okay, let us walk. The Bible says, if two of you shall agree on touching of anything, here on earth it shall be done with your Father in heaven. They start walking. They were just in fall. Your miracle is not in sitting down. Your miracle is in that action that you're going to take from today. In the name of Jesus. They start walking. Every time they put their feet on the ground, there were a mighty vibration in the camp of the enemy. They didn't know about it. But God was working behind the scene to bring miracles for these four lepers. If God walked behind the scene before God to bring miracles to those four lepers, I just want you to know that even if you don't know what is happening when you are sleeping, God is walking behind the scene to bring your miracle in the name of Jesus. The Bible says God caused the Syrian's army to hear a mighty army coming against them. A mighty army. That's what God is going to do for you from today. The Bible says one of you will chase 1,000 and two of you shall chase 10,000. Every time you show up, your appearance will scare your enemies in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Every time they walked, they were might. God caused a might vibration to these people. Just imagine there were a confusion in the camp of the enemy until they didn't know how to run. You know when you're on a horse, you run much faster than using your natural feet. Amen? But they forget even to ride on the horses. They left the horses back. They left the chariot back. That was a great confusion in the camp of the enemy. And I declare this afternoon that the same thing will happen to those who are pursuing you. There will be a great confusion in the camp of your enemies. The Bible says they will come in one way, but they will flee in seven ways. That's what is going to happen in your life right now. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. They didn't know how to run. How to run. The Bible says they were running for their lives. And these four lepers, they didn't know God is doing something for them. That's why I'm saying, do something. God is working behind the scene to bring things to pass. In the name of Jesus. Do something. Turn to your neighbor and tell him, oh, do something. When they entered into the camps, they found they are not yet. They are not there. They have already fled. Hallelujah. But just imagine if they could be sitting down, they could have dead where they were. But they took action. Do something. Hallelujah. They entered into one. They were leprous. These were lepers with nothing. But overnight, they became rich. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. in Jesus' name. Whosoever wants you to die poor, you shall not die poor. Your God is walking behind the scene. Hallelujah. These were four lepers, and they became rich people overnight. They were encouraging themselves. Man, inside in their hearts, they were fear. Fear of death. But they decided, anyway, we're going to go. Hallelujah. Being courageous is not the absence of fear. No. You feel fear sometimes. You feel fear confronting things sometimes. Fear of failing. Fear of losing your money. Every rich person in this world, he will tell you that whatever they started, they didn't have that. It doesn't mean that they were not fearing of losing their money. No. They know they can lose their money. But they decided, anyway, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do this. Hallelujah. When they were walking, they were fear. I don't know if I'm going to die. Maybe this is my last day in this world. But they continue walking. They continue walking. They were looking to each other. Maybe this is your last day in this world. But let us go anyway. They continue walking anyway. Why? Where they are going is where their miracles here are. Hallelujah. When they reached there, they were left outside to die. They found food. The Bible says they ate. The first thing they did, they ate. Hallelujah. The first thing you need to do, when God opens the door for you, the number one thing is for you to take care of yourself. First of all, they ate. They didn't say that, oh, let us go and take food in the camp. No. Let us be filled first. They ate first. They ate. To start with, maybe they're coming. No one is around. Let's continue eating. They ate until they were full. And when they were full, they looked around. Oh my God, there's gold here. Silver. Bronze. Hallelujah. The Bible says they collected gold and silver. Man, you came here broke. They continued with them. They ran and hid them. They came back. They went to another tent. They found the same thing. They hid the money, silver, and gold. They hid them. And then when they were satisfied, and then they, okay, we can remember others now. It is time to remember our brethren. It is time to remember my brother, whatever he is. It is time now to take care of my relatives. It is time now to take care of those who cared for me. Now it is time. Where are they? Let's go and tell them good news. Let me tell you, people of God, good news. This morning, do something. God is walking behind the scene to make things into fruition. He will bring every dream into fruition. Raka Pokosaka, another person, was Hannah. Let me tell you the story of Hannah. The story of Hannah. I've got to do something. Hallelujah. Every step you will take, God will bring it into fruition. God will bring it into fruition. Hallelujah. God is waiting on you you need in this world. Do something. Things will be attracted to you when you start doing something.
Declare this afternoon before you hit the
those two doors going outside, something must happen in your life. Shout hallelujah. Before you hit in your car, something must happen tonight. Shout hallelujah. You are in Shiloh. In the zone where all things are possible. Is that true? Hallelujah. There is a man of God. Man of God. I just want to read that thing. Julian, please. With your respect, can you go in that office there and bring my phone in that little bag there? I just want to read you something. When you come in the house of God, where you are sitting right now, that is your miracle. Where you are sitting in those pews right now, you have your answers right now. Right there. It is because sometimes we are not aware of the presence of God. God is here this afternoon, shout hallelujah. God is here this afternoon, shout hallelujah. He's here to give you a miracle. Shout hallelujah. Hannah. Verse 10. And she was in bitterness of soul and prayed to the Lord and wept in anguish. Verse 11. Then she made a vow and say, O Lord of hosts, if you indeed look on the affliction of your maidservant and remember me, and not forget your maidservant, but will give your maidservant a male child, then I will give him to the Lord all the days of his life, and no razor shall come upon his head. Hallelujah. She prayed and said, God of hosts, if you remember your maidservant today and give her a maidservant, a married child, she made a vow. Let me tell you, people of God, today is the day your name to be remembered. Shout hallelujah. Today is the day for your name to be remembered. In the name of Jesus. It will be remembered for the impossible things that you have been trusting God for. What has made you to be a laughter? This is for everybody who is watching and everybody. Whatever has made you to be a laughter, today is going to be transformed. It's going to be changed for good. In Jesus' name. And the Lord opened her womb and she gave her birth, for the greatest prophet ever lived, Prophet Samuel. Can you shout hallelujah? This is what happened when she was praying. Mistaken her, and she named her as a drunkard woman. But she was not a drunk. Let me read it. So Eli said to her, how long, verse 14, so Eli said to her, how long will you be drunk? Put your wine away from you. Hallelujah. We don't care what names people have put on you. You have been called so many names. People have named you evil names. But let me tell you this afternoon, we serve a mighty God who can change your name overnight. He changed his soul to Paul. He will change your status today from being called a prostitute to being called a preacher. Jesus. God will give you a Samuel today in the name of Jesus. Shout hallelujah. Raka posetereaba. Sekoraba. This was the servant of God. We normally have occasional meetings. He has been coming in our meetings, for those who have been here in our special meetings, and has been sitting down there with his wife. His wife had a brain stroke. Brain stroke. Let me read this. Is there a text? He texted me. Let me read the portion that I want you to hear. I may read the whole thing. Thank you, man of God. I receive it in Jesus' holy name. Hallelujah to the Lord, to the Lamb of God. I just want to praise God. That's my heart desire. Thank you, man of God. We'll praise the Lord. This is a test. No one will text you to read. I'm reading it. I'm quoting it. Let me say, I'm quoting it. We'll praise the Lord, Pastor. This is Minister McCoy, Prophet McCoy. I would like to thank you again for your prayer that you, for everything that you study in the Word of Christ. I feel prayers. Get prepared for. Let me read the testimony. Let me read the testimony. Say testimony. I praise the Lord, Pastor. This is Minister McCoy. That my wife came, and you are welcome. And my wife came to your church. She had two brain strokes, and she went to the hospital after you prayed for her. And you spoke these words that the devil's case was closed through the Holy Ghost in a service one night. She went back to the doctor and got a report. She don't have to take any insulin and sugar used to get up to 300. She doesn't have to take medicine. You understood well all things are possible. Shout with me. You understood well all things are possible. God is in the business. But you have to go. You have to do something. Shout hallelujah. God is here. If you didn't know, God is here. If you didn't know, God is here. Let me give you the final example. I'm continuing. This was part one. I'm going to continue with part two next week. Blind Bartimaeus. I have to do something. Blind Bartimaeus. In Mark chapter 10, verse 46 to 52, the Bible says, now they came to Jericho. As he went out of Jericho with his disciples and a great multitude, blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, sat by the road begging. And when he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began crying out and said, Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. Then many wanted him to be quiet. But he cried out all the more, son of David, have mercy on me. So Jesus stood still and commanded him to be called. Then they called him the blind Bartimaeus, saying to him, be of good cheer, rise, he is calling you. And through It is time to fight back. Yes. Let me ask you to stand up where you are. Raka poko setereaba. Hapa zite ketereaba. Reba yamo koposa. You are going to do something. You are going to do something. With that situation, you are going to do something. With the financial act, you are going to do something. Sickness, you are going to do something. Blind Bartimaeus heard about Jesus Christ. That the person who is passing by here today, you know, Jesus was supposed to pass there. And I know he was a man in the marketplace. People were talking and saying, you know what? The man who is coming, the one who passed here today, is a healer. He heals people. Every time people come across him, whatever you have, whatever sickness you have, that will be the end of it. And the Bartimaeus were listening. There were so many blind people around there. There were so many people begging there. Maybe there were also lepers there. But blind Bartimaeus, something happened within him. He knew this man who is passing by here, he has my miracle. He has what I need. And when the time comes and Jesus Christ was in that place, in the right spot, he shouted, "Jesus Christ, Son of David, have mercy on me." As usual, there will be people who will try to silence you. There will be people try to keep you quiet. They tried to blind Bartimaeus. Oh man, you need to keep quiet. This is Jesus Christ. Don't you understand? This is Jesus Christ. Very respected. He's a prophet. Hallelujah. Bartimaeus said, "What? I've been in this situation all my years and you want me to keep quiet? I'm not going to keep quiet. Jesus Christ, Son of David, have mercy on me." He won't care for you. He won't care for you. Don't you see? You are just a beggar lamb. What? Jesus Christ, Son of David, have mercy on me. He won't care for you. You are a blind person. You can't. I don't care. And the more they wanted him to shut down, the Bible says, the more he shouted, the more he shouted, the more he shouted. Whatever you are doing, keep on doing it, even if no one approves you. Hallelujah. Whatever you are doing, keep on doing it. Even if it's hard right now, keep on doing it. One day, you will reap the fruit of what you're doing. The boy shouted, and Jesus Christ stood and said, "Hey, call him. Come on." And when they had the same people who once upon time they wanted him to keep quiet, the same people ran to him. "Oh, he's calling you." Let me tell you, people of God, the same people who are laughing at you right now, who are mocking at you now, tomorrow they will come and rest.
The same people. Hallelujah. The same people. Who are right now, they don't want to see you, will be the same people who will ask your telephone number tomorrow. The same people who don't send invitation letters to you will be the same people who will invite you to be the guest of honor. Rabokopokosakata. In the name of Jesus. It is happening. Shout hallelujah. It is happening. Shout hallelujah. Rabokoseketerea. I grew up in this place. When I was growing up, I didn't have anything. But later on, one time I was in college, I went back, I had money for research. I was given money for research. So I had money that time. And I was sitting in that house. And that person came. A young man wanted to marry. As usual, in our culture, we have tendency of helping one another. So this young man was in the house, was asking for somebody to sponsor him to get married. And I was there in my heart. I was like, if he asked me, I've already even prepared how much I'm going to give him. But because this young man, he knew the old Johanna. Even by that time, he knew Johanna doesn't have any money, so he didn't pay attention to me. Yay! Hallelujah! Your season is coming. Your season is coming. Right now, no one takes notes of you. But in 2-3 years to come, you will be the hot cake in the city. You will be the hot demand in the city. I declare that to happen in the name of Jesus. You will be the high demand in the city. Because God is going to bless you. Hallelujah. Because God is going to open doors for you that no man can open. They are going to open in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Whatever you are doing, keep on doing it in Jesus' name. Remember the blind Bartimaeus. Keep on shouting. Keep on shouting. Keep on shouting. They will come and they will bless you. In Jesus' name. Raise up your hands. I will continue with this until next week. Thank the Lord for the message. Thank the Lord for the message, because your time is coming. You have to do something. You have to do something in the name of Jesus. It is overdue what you have been doing, and you get nothing. But right now, you have to do something in the name of Jesus. Raka poko zeka tere abaraba sheka. Remaya poko zeka tere. In Jesus. Praise God. You have to do something. You have to do something. Your enemy, whatever you do, he doesn't love you. He's not your friend. He's not your friend. The situation you have will never change by itself. You may be here, or you may be watching. You may say, I have everything. I don't need Jesus. I don't need what you are talking about. Let me say this. You need Jesus. Amen. You need him. Hallelujah. You need him. Be vigilant. Since the day of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffers violence. And the violent take it by force. Who make us energy, the power that will make you go through 6 days before we meet one another here again. And you are here, you want to go home empty. An empty tank can stop the car at any time, anywhere in the highway. If you didn't know. Don't go in the gas station and get out of gas station without refueling your vehicle.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. What you get here will help you,
yes, Lord,
to go against every obstacle, every attack, every arrows that the enemy will shoot at you. Something is wrong in your body, it is you, not your husband, not your wife. So when you are in this kind of atmosphere, you make things happen.
Amen.
Hannah was like a drunken woman. She didn't care. Eli was there. Her husband was there. She didn't care. She became like a drunken woman. Why? She was the one who was enduring laughter, disrespect in the community, not her husband. Raka poko sakata. Now, I'm going to count to three. I want you to thank the Lord because you missed something. I want you to do something in your life. Anything that you want the Lord to do for you in this week, He will do it. He will do it, amen? He will do it, amen? He will do it, amen? There are people who are registered in heaven as servants of God. When they speak, God listens. If you didn't know, it was Eli who said to Hannah,
Yeka poko saka kasete. Rema ya moko.
This secret, this mystery, every person you see mouth of a human being saying to them, saying, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. I declare peace upon you this afternoon. I declare the blessings of God upon you this afternoon. I declare divine protection upon you this afternoon. I declare and nullify every arrow from the devil against you in the name of Jesus. And the Bible says in verse 27, God said, so they shall put my name on the children of Israel, and I will bless them. That they will declare my name upon them. And when they have done that, I will bless them. Let God bless you mysteriously in the name of Jesus. Let the Lord open the doors that are still closed in the name of Jesus. Let the grace of God be upon you in the name of Jesus. Let those who hate you be hated by God. In the name of Jesus. Shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let your enemy be the enemy of your God. Yes. In the name of Jesus. Let those who pursue you be pursued by God. In the name of Jesus. Shout hallelujah. Let those who curse you be cursed by God. In the name of Jesus. It shall be so. You are a blessed woman of God. You are a blessed man of God. In Jesus' name. Can we clap our hands to our God? In the name of Jesus. You may be seated in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Let's go ahead and give our offerings to our God and our tithes to our God. Can we clap our hands to our God, please?